keep you in the shade so you don't get too hot. Sorry, I know I'm videoing off my phone, but I bought a camera because tools are much more important to get. That's why I just bought a brand new air ratchet and a plasma cutter. So, as far as videoing goes, I go with what I got. Alright, so we'll get this down. Start with this guy. Set in there. I have these two. Started. Okay. So, and my bolts. Alright. I suppose what I can do, I got you up in here. We'll put you down here a little closer to where I don't have to stand up to do this. So, I need all my stuff. That's right there. So, a half inch socket. And for right now, my half inch socket. No, that's the way you came apart. You know what? See what the problem is? Apparently when I was driving things around, bearing needs to be driven back down on this piece. So, let's see here. Get enough persuasion on it. smidgen more. There we go. So, if you look on the inside, you can see, if I can get, you can see that. Maybe you can see it. Alright, I can roll it. Can you? There's a snap ring in there. There you can see it. So it's just got to come up against that snap ring. Now I can reinstall it. I might make these fit a little better. Hot washer on that one, but there was one, so it's actually got a lock nut on it. Nuts are kind of buggered up a little. The outside threads on the nuts are buggered up a little, so I have to start them that way. So I don't have a snap ring for this other end of this one yet, but I'll get one. I'll go ahead and get this put together. There we go. Now I can hit over at the air. If I can find my air. Probably sticking them. There's my air. I want to drive a socket on that nut, I'll never get it off. Thank you. pretty easy to figure out which way it's got to go, because this would bend. Oh yeah, it's got to go down in there like that anyway. Look how far that sits over there for that. Go ahead and do that. So what I'm going to do, take the old reef gun, smear some grease on this thing, definitely is lubricated well. It just starts falling off there on its own. Now we need this little guy. This is the engagement lever. And there's a, well, there's another one here. There's a little spacer that goes in there. It's a little bit wobbly, not bad. That goes in there. But you know what? I think it does. I might have to go back and check. Pretty sure it goes in that way. All right, now. This one. Yeah, I'm not sure if it looks like that. So go here. Okay, so I do have to flip this around. Now it hits that. You know what? Actually, I think I need to turn that one around. Flip it like that. This one goes here. And then this one goes here. Yeah, because that way it will allow it to lock into place. There we go. Yeah. little warm out here. Yeah, you're starting. Just making sure. Alright, so now I gotta get my little knobber. Spin that one on there. And the big thing is, this was not a restoration by any stretch of the imagination. If you want, you can call it a restoration. It was just, I had some problems with it. I needed to get it fixed so I could get it working. So I needed it working. So now, we're gonna put this all back on the tractor. So, keep doing that. Go on there. Like show. This one goes on there like so. Put a washer or a nut as a spacer in there. A 5/16 bolt, and I put a ⅜ nut in it. Just fold that over a little. So show you what I'm talking about. So this also arm attaches to this, but if I suck it all the way over where that's tight, it's actually touching this brake drum right here. So I just took and spaced it out with a 3/8 nut in there, tightened her down a little. She ain't going nowhere. And I still got a little bit of room in there. So that will work. I'll go ahead and get that inner belt on. Thank you. down to make sure. Here's my cotter pin. You know what? It's supposed to be on the other side, that's why. Alright. I knew it was going to take me a little bit to get this thing back together. I see what the problem is. I think I see what the problem is. Like that. Alright, I'm gonna have to go back and look at my video. Alright. That's why we take videos. In a second, I got it figured out. So, this guy off. This. Put them upside down. This. And things will work right. I will get this figured out. Washers on the right stuff. This one goes here. Wait a minute. All right, I gotta look again. Thank you.
Oh, okay. Maybe help put a belt on.
Put the belt on right. It goes down here. I had it on the top, so that's a problem. Dummy hasn't figured out how to put the belt on correctly. So now, tighten that up. Now the drive is actually back complete. All that BS because I couldn't figure out how to put the belt on. Guy lifted back up. Some of these nuts I should have replaced, but I didn't. Oh, it feels cheap. There we go. Alright, so now that the drive is on correctly, it makes a big difference. You can actually spin. Now we can put this tire back on. Don't tell anybody I did that. I got my red dish to figure out. Alright. I'll get this tire back on and we'll get the tiller on. Alright. That's her all back together. And then to actually engage it, right now it's just running because, I mean, it's around the pulley that's spinning and I don't have a belt stop. To actually engage it and pull that up, now it's actually engaged where it'll keep spinning. So I'll set you up out here, maybe do a little bit of tilling with her. Alright, I'm going to get the AC. So that's going across her twice with the tiller. I'm actually getting ready to put sod in here, so I just wanted to work it up a little. I got to clean up along the edges, but I still got a bunch of peat moss to drop in here, some lime, some gypsum. It didn't look like it was doing a whole lot. This is all just really hard clay up here. But some of the interesting items I dug out of the yard. Somebody lost themselves a cap. That's a perfectly good cap if you want it. Let me know and I will definitely send you that. Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that cap. And then I believe that is a starter relay for a notch from the looks of it. Yeah, dug that up out of there too. And sticks and all kinds of goodies. Chunks of aluminum. Chunks of old garden edging. Okay.